Welcome, my friends. Oh my goodness, I didn't know I had so many friends. Thanks for being here. We've got a great show for you tonight, as Stephen Colbert says. I have the good fortune of playing with a wonderful band tonight. Don Clement on piano. Domi Edson on bass. And Clare Church, one of the co-owners of this marvelous Muse performance space, on drums. Yes! And they're going to start off with a little tune that has to do with whatever month we're in. And I'm sure you'll know it.
Thank you.
Wow. Did you? Okay. For those of you who are watching this on streaming, and a few friends of mine from out of state are, there's a place to donate to the Muse, and that's right above the top of the screen if you want to donate to these fabulous musicians. So just wanted you to know that. The restrooms are around the corner. This Muse Performance Space is a nonprofit that is run by Clare and her wonderful husband, saxophone player Pete Lewis, and they have just provided an amazing venue for all of us. So thank you, Clare. Are we still working on sound? Yes?
Sorry, working on sound.
Okay. I will talk about the next piece, which is something I wrote, huh? Yeah, I wrote a piece. The name of it means absolutely nothing. It just came to me as I was waking up one day. It's called Crown Chantus. It means absolutely nothing. I looked it up. I thought maybe it meant something.
Forgive
her. She's always... Clare is also the sound person, so... She wears many hats. Is that it?
Yes.
Got it? Okay, and if you guys, if the sound isn't right, like somebody's too loud or what...
Just yell it out.
Just yell it out.
Okay.
We'll figure it out. This ain't Beethoven. So we'll do this piece. Crown Chantus, written by moi.
Thank you.
Okay, so violin is up, piano is down, talk mic is down, and we should be good to go.
We got the violin up in the house.
Yes, violin's up in the house, but
down in the lights for sure.
Hello. Okay, sometimes it takes a little bit of adjusting because we're kind of like chiropractors. You know, we're always adjusting. There's always something a little off. Clare has to announce his next piece, so I'm just waiting for her to.
Oh, is it mine?
It is. Oh, okay. Our next piece is a tune by Clare.
Church.
Okay, so this is actually one of the first tunes I ever wrote. I wrote it in 1984, I think, and it's been improved since then. I've, you know, made the chord changes better and improved on it, but I wrote it, I just sat down at the piano and wrote it in about an hour and a half, and then there it was, and it's called Kindred Spirits. It's obviously for Pete. Those of you that know my husband Pete, we've been together since 1983, married since 85. Yes, we were living in sin for a couple of years, so it was just, we just like were so compatible. We went to the counseling, you know, before we got married, and the guy said, You two are maybe the most compatible people I've ever seen. We were both saxophone players and just both outdoorsy, and, you know, we were just a match made in heaven, still going strong. Anyway, I wrote this tune called Kindred Spirits for Pete and me, mostly for Pete.
Thank you.
Kindred Spirits by Clare Church. These are almost all originals except the first and the last song, so that's what we're doing tonight. This next piece is a gorgeous ballad by Domi, and I'm going to let her tell you about it.
This song is called Lila, which is the Hebrew word for night. As a Jewish person, I've always had sort of an interesting relationship with Christmas. On one hand, I mean, starting October, it's everywhere. Like the lighting in the street, the music in the shops. Most TV shows have a Christmas episode. People will ask, hey, what are you doing over the Christmas break? And it's just a daily, if not bi-daily, like reminder that, you know, I'm part of a minority group. And I feel, you know, kind of left out. But on the other hand, like I have lots of really close friends and some extended family who celebrate Christmas, and I see how much joy it brings them, and I ask them, how can I be like kind of bitter or resentful over a holiday that brings millions and millions of people joy? So I've always sort of felt conflicted about it, and rather than talk about it all day, I wrote this song called Lila.
Thank you. Thank you.
Okay, let's just go home. My God, that was so beautiful. This next piece, I'm throwing a couple on this set, and one of them is to honor one of my mentors. I was very lucky to study theory and masterclass and combos with David Baker. And this is one of his tunes called Passion. I believe his widow, Lida, might be watching. Hi, Lida. And maybe his daughter, April, as well. So if you're out there, this is also for you, Lida and April. David Baker's Passion. Thank you. That was Passion by David Baker. Thank you, David. This next tune is something that I wrote, and I wrote it with the victims of the Marshall Fire in mind. I know of some musicians that have lost their homes. And it also seems to be relevant now to what is going on in Ukraine, so I'm kind of doubly dedicating it to that as well. The name of the song is Ash by Me. Thank you. We're throwing in something in the middle here that we just sort of thought up about 1 minute before the doors open. So this is going to be like jazz. We're just sort of, I mean, we know the tune, but how we're doing it is we just sort of half decided. So we'll see what happens here. This is In Walked Bud by Thelonious Monk.
Thank you.
Well, that was a great experiment, and I tried to follow along. kudos to Don Clement on piano, Domi Edson on bass, and Clare Church on drums, yes. We have one more that I'm doing from a mentor friend of mine. That's a tune by Javier Arau, who runs the New York Jazz Academy, and I've been lucky enough to go to New York and take a bunch of classes with them, go to Cuba with them, Panama Jazz Festival with them a number of times, so where we just came back. So this is Javier's tune, Kick a Few Leaves. Thank you guys, you've been a swell audience. We're going to close with another April-ish tune called I'll Remember April. Don't forget April. Thank you so much for coming. Make sure and donate to The Muse, which is a wonderful nonprofit. If you're online and watching this, the information about Venmo and PayPal, etc., is above on the screen above, not in real life. Guys are wondering what I'm talking about, but thank you so very much, and we'll close with I'll Remember April.
Thank you.
thanks to these wonderful musicians for following along when I went somewhere else. I don't know where. Don Clement on piano. Domi Edson on bass. Clare Church on drums. And I'm Jane Uitti. Thank you so much. We have merch. We have merch. Somebody brought CDs. Domi brought some CDs, so they're back there somewhere. Talk to her about them. They're wonderful. It's wonderful or they're wonderful? What, did you bring one? She brought one, which is called Without the Ray. And if you can understand what it means, talk to Domi about it. And go, buy one from her. It's wonderful. Good night.